Hey everyone, John Henry here from School of Trade. Today we're going to be taking a look at a fake out breakout on the low side here on the S&P. Now, it hasn't triggered yet, but I'm looking at an entry at 17.5 to ride the move back up. We have been seeing a relatively nice down day overall. If we zoom out, it's pretty clear that we do have a bear trend working lower, but that bear trend working down here is getting weaker and weaker and weaker, right? We had that initial push down, they had a nice breakthrough, and then a little bit less of a breakthrough and now a very weak breakthrough before trying to turn back up again. So I'm looking for the sellers really just to want to take profit. They're going to see this move down as weaker, right? And just like we're seeing it as weaker. So they're not going to want to try to hold on for as large a targets. And that means that you'll probably expect to see a larger correction back higher before seeing the sellers take it back down again. So I'm looking for a long here at 17.5 with this little fake break to the lows, and primarily looking up initially to break this high up here. So let me get my entry right there. Sell stop below the low. Looking for my first target to come off at this high up here because I want to see it break through that high. So that's going to be my first target at 22.5. The next target, I'm going to be looking for only one contract on this last bit, primarily just back up to retest this bigger move over here, and want to do about the exact same thing. So initial stop is going to go below the low. As we have more confirmation of this move, then we'll be looking to hang on to it for a little bit, of a tighter stop. But for right now, looking to gun back towards these highs over here at 22.5. And that's mainly because all of the sellers who are trying to hang on to this have their stops above that high. And usually in corrective mode, when we go into a correction, we want to hit those stops. So I want my target right at the high at 22.5 so we can trigger through it and get those stops ran. And then looking for the final one up at 25 and three quarter for that last portion for the exact same reason. So from our entry point here to that first target, I'm looking at a run up of 5.25 points. And then the second target, looking at 8.5. Now, the reason I'm taking three off here at this high and only one off later is because I don't know how big the correction's going to be, so I'm going to be a little more conservative on the first target and assume that we probably won't get up here given that we're in a bearish trend. But you never know. So just because of you never know, I'm going to put one contract up there and take three off. Just be a little bit safer in that regard. So we'll give it a little bit of time here. We are pushing up aggressively into that target. We've already come one tick away from that first target. Now we just need to see a little bit more follow-through, get those stops on the highs ran, and then we should be able to push up to that 25 and three quarter point next. So we'll give it a little bit of time and see if we can get that grind higher. We can see the buyers pushing back up towards the highs. We're a couple ticks away from our target. I moved my stop up a little bit here at 15.5, primarily because I don't really want to see them come back. I want to see them go through this level and never worry about coming all the way back down again. And there we get the target filled. So with the target filled, we're going to go down to one contract left, and we're looking for that final push up to the highs. Now, given how strong of a move this was to the upside, I'm going to use a little bit of the profit that we had built in on this move higher to allow me to keep my stop back a little ways. And that's just mainly because we are seeing this as very choppy. The downtrend sellers are going to want to get back in this move to try to drive it lower. And the buyers are anticipated to try to defend these lows at their position around 17 quarter where we're in long right now. So I want to see a little bit more follow-through here to get that final target, but understanding the fact that we do have a bear trend in play, they're very likely to want to come back to retest this area to see, hey, are the buyers still interested? Do you guys still want it? We're here again, right? Do you want to get back in at the same price or what's going on? And if they fail, I want to get out of the trade anyway. So that's why my stop is at 15.5. So hopefully this will go quick and we won't have to worry about that pullback. But if we do, my stop is back at 15.5 just to try to weather as much of it as we can. So we'll be back in a little bit and we'll see if we can get that last target up at 25 and three quarter. Seeing the buyers push up very aggressively now, I'm going to lock my stop in underneath here, this little pullback that we saw. They did come back as anticipated. They wanted to play around at that level. We get the target filled too. Let me close that. They came back to play around at that break-even point, and they hit it and immediately rejected right back up. That showed that the buyers kind of understood what was going on. They probably did the same thing. There were likely a lot of people who got stopped out of the move and missed that run higher, but smart traders more likely had a big old buy order resting right there to pop that thing back up again. So that's going to be the trade, a beautiful fake out on the lows here, just looking for that correction back up to sort of disprove, that although the sellers are in, they're also going to want to take profit, seeing it get weaker and weaker and weaker. And this one was the last straw right here. They push down aggressively and immediately fire right back up. That's a big clue that we're likely to see a little bit of a correction. So now we're in the corrective phase. I'm still anticipating the sellers to want to take it back down to the lows, but until this correction is over, we have to be sitting on the long side. So that's going to do it for me. Overall, a beautiful trade. We were able to pull in a pretty nice trade overall. Especially for only four contracts, 1,200 on the trade itself. Now at 1,250 a tick, that's 96 ticks total. So beautiful profit on the trade, relatively textbook in terms of a fake out, especially given the context of the day. But if you have any questions about it, feel free to send an email to School of Trade. Don't forget to check out our trial at schoolofthetrade.com. And as always, we'll catch you next time.